In the previous installment, we looked closely at our subject as if through a microscope and practiced cataloging what we saw, being careful to stay away from judgment or abstraction. We'll practice the same thing here with a strategy called the method. But this time, we'll look for patterns of repetition, contrast, and anomaly. As always, keep in mind the golden rule of analysis. Acknowledge and suspend your bad habits of mind, such as generalization, snap judgment, overpersonalizing, and offering opinions versus ideas. The first step of the method is to look for details or words that repeat, and say how many times each detail is repeated. This time, let's look at a poem by Theodor Rethke. It's entitled Night Crow. Night Crow. When I saw that clumsy crow flap from a wasted tree, a shape in the mind rose up. Over the gulfs of dream flew a tremendous bird, further and further away, into a moonless black, deep in the brain, far back. Since this is a short poem, we don't have a lot of raw material to work with, but even so, there are several repetitions. The word crow and the word further are both repeated twice. If you were looking at a painting or a film, you might look for colors, scenes, objects, or dialogue that's repeated. Isolating repetitions in this way helps you begin to see what the subject is interested in talking about or showing. Next, make another list, but this time look for groups of similar kinds of details or words. For example, the words elegant, stylish, graceful are not exactly the same, but they have similar meaning and connotation. Let's take a look at some possible groupings we came up with. You can decide how you want to group details. For instance, crow, bird, tree, and brain were grouped together because they share a physical presence. They are things to touch or to see. But gulfs, deep, tremendous, and far are grouped because they describe or convey a similar sense of vastness. However you group details, make sure the category that you apply makes sense to you. Now that we've noticed some repetitions and similarities, let's list the contrasts, or things that are in binary opposition to one another. Look first for explicit contrasts, or ones that are pretty obvious. Here are a few possibilities. Both of these groupings describe contrasting movements. Next, look for implicit contrasts, or ones that aren't quite as obvious. You'll notice that here, we've made groupings that may not at first seem like contrasts, such as saw and dream. The contrast we're highlighting here is one between waking and sleeping. You might also notice that brain, mind is a grouping we listed under similarities. It may sometimes happen that you can categorize details so that they contrast with or mirror one another. Here, we reasoned that the brain was a tangible, physical organ of the body, and that the mind might point to its intangible, non-physical counterpart. But these two words can also be used as synonyms in everyday discourse. When this happens, it simply makes those details more interesting because they have the potential for multiple meanings. As with notice and rank, we're now going to pull out the two most significant or interesting or strange repetitions from our previous list, and the two most significant, strange, or interesting contrasts. Here is what we came up with. For repetitions, clumsy, wasted. Gulfs, deep, tremendous, and far. For contrasts, clumsy crow, tremendous bird. and saw dream. By this point in the process, simply by noticing and ranking groups of details, you will likely have begun formulating some larger ideas about the poem and what it's trying to say. Now, zero in on one detail from the previous list that you find to be the most significant or interesting or strange, and write a paragraph explaining your choice. Here's an example. We chose Clumsy Crow, Tremendous Bird. The contrast between the clumsy crow and the tremendous bird seems significant because it calls to mind such disparate images. The crow in this poem is not extraordinary. Because it flaps on a wasted tree and is clumsy, it comes off as debilitated and lacking in agency. The tremendous bird, in contrast, comes across as large, powerful, and capable of winging its way over vast areas. It's interesting that the tremendous bird rises up in the mind, while the clumsy crow exists only in the material world. Note, you can repeat this step with any number of observations. Finally, look for anomalies in your subject, things that do not seem odd or do not seem to fit. It's useful to leave this step until the end because it can often help us see something we overlooked before, or it can help disrupt any snap judgments or generalizations we may have begun formulating. Write a sentence explaining each anomaly that you find. Here's an example. It seems unusual that a crow would be depicted as weak and clumsy, since crows are known to be among the world's smartest and most environmentally flexible birds. In the next installment, we'll step further, past observations and into ideas about the subject.